The following is a presentation of Patrick McSpare Productions. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to more WWE 2K18 My Career Mode, as we are just two nights removed from the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view. If you missed the last episode, Patrick Murphy wrote a good ending to Mighty Casey as he came back to beat Dolph Ziggler in match number 5 in the Best of 5 series. But now it is time for the ultimate thrill ride as we are on the road to WrestleMania. Nikki Bella, why are you still in front of my car? I'm just looking forward to watching your match at the next pay-per-view. Just remember, you're going out there to represent this great company. A win for you will earn respect from not only me, but management as well. Whatever, Nikki, you're already, never mind. You know, this is what I gotta put up with each and every week, you know? It's just a little bit ridiculous, you know? I shouldn't have to put up with some of the lip service or anything like this magnitude, ladies and gentlemen. It is beyond me, and I shouldn't have to put up with it, you know? And Patrick Murphy has come out to have a strong showing, ladies and gentlemen. He came out to have a strong showing against Dolph Ziggler. As we take a look at some of the company man and fan favorite stuff right here, Patrick Murphy is now finally on a roll on the main roster, people. He's won 3 matches in a row, and you gotta believe that's gotta put him in position to appear at his first WrestleMania, ladies and gentlemen. Whether or not that'll actually happen or not, that will be a long ways away, as Patrick Murphy has some stuff to prove, not only to himself, but also to management. I think Patrick Murphy could eventually be in contention for the United States Championship, which we don't know who the title holder is currently right now, but you got to think somewhere down the road, he's got to be in contention for the United States Championship at some point. Whether or not it'll happen somewhere. Epico, what are you doing? You're always sitting there on your phone texting. So you've been pretty impressive in the ring. Really impressive. But to make it to the top, you need more than flashy moves, my friend. Oh, yeah? Is that what you think, Epico, Mr. Loudmouth? No, it's what I know. What you say is just as important. You haven't shown that you can get the crowd over to hang on off your every word. So why don't you go out there and whip this crowd into a frenzy? You want a frenzy? I'll have them all eating out of the palms of my hands when I'm done. It's easy to talk a big game out here. Let's see you get it done out there. So this is another side quest that we'll accept. But because it's a side quest that really only involves a promo, we are not going to show that week of SmackDown Live, ladies and gentlemen. Because that was originally supposed to be the original episode 19, but We're not going to show that. Victor. Yeah. No, Connor. Mm-hmm. Sir! You realize who you're talking to right here? Oh, God. Why do I got to put up with face-painted freaks like you? I shouldn't have to put up with the disrespect. Whatever, I'm already done. Tyler Breeze, I'm not going to go talk to you. I'm going to get an interview with Renee Young. It looks like you're in a full-blown rivalry. What are your thoughts on that? First off, Renee, what rivalry are you talking about? This is exactly what I've been wanting. No rivalries. A real feud down the line. But you know what, Renee? How am I supposed to talk about a feud when I'm not even in one? So, unless you want me to stay in this interview area, why don't you ask me a real damn question to the real deal heel? Have you ever second-guessed being a WWE superstar? Is there another career you consider? Really? Renee? Oh, God. I don't understand the question. That's like asking someone if they've ever considered not breathing. I don't like it when you ask me a dumbass question like this. I'm a WWE superstar for life, you stupid idiot. End of story. Why don't you go cry to Mr. Dean Ambrose, you little phony, you scum. This interview is over.
Thanks for your time. Back to you.
Oh, Patrick Murphy. I'm telling you, he's already been put in a bad mood. And now we're going to advance forward a little bit here backstage. So we're going to sit here and make our way to the production area where Mr. Todd Mullen is waiting for us. So, wait a minute. Shane O'Mac, my main man. You know what? I ain't got time for you just yet, my friend. There's nothing, and there's nobody in my locker room. This is perfect. Outside of people getting on my backside, Todd, let's hope we can have a good night tonight. Good.
How are you holding up this road trip? We just finalized the match card. Take a look.
Oh, okay, so what we got going for us tonight, Todd? Hopefully something good. Something good that we could probably steal the show. Because tonight on SmackDown Live, Patrick Murphy will be in action against the former ROH Dojo graduate and ROH upstart, Cedric Alexander. Wow, that has the potential to be a show stealer, as this is SmackDown Live. This crowd is pumped up as we continue the road to WrestleMania as it stops in North Charleston, South Carolina, as this is SmackDown Live. And tonight we got a special treat for you, ladies and gentlemen, as tonight the real deal heel Patrick Murphy takes up former ROH rookie and current 205 Live star that made a huge impression in the Cruiserweight Classic, Mr. Cedric Alexander. This match is sponsored by Troop. Hashtag finish it with Troop. Has made shockwaves on the main roster. Yes, he only has 4 victories on the main roster. 1 against Braun Strowman and 3 against Dolph Ziggler. Just coming off the recent classic that was the best of 5 series. Patrick Murphy has more to prove that he's more than just a flash in the pan. A lot of people have doubted his ability in the past, and they have also doubted whether or not he has what it takes to make it on the main roster. Anything he can do tonight to erase those doubts, he'll be willing to do it. As tonight, Patrick Murphy is in action on SmackDown Live. Cedric Alexander, the native from Charlotte, North Carolina, is best known for his time in Ring of Honor. He teamed up with a lot of tag team partners, but his best known longtime tag team partner was Caprice Coleman. Cedric Alexander would make shockwaves in Ring of Honor. However, he would not get the due spotlight until last year at the Cruiserweight Classic. But tonight, 2 North Carolina natives will go at it as Patrick Murphy and Cedric Alexander are prepared to steal the show. And there you see both men getting up, getting ready. This should be a wild one. And here we go. Bell is sounded, and Patrick Murphy goes for the uppercut early, and Patrick Murphy not pulling any punches, and there's a knife edge chop, clothesline into the Bulldog. Patrick Murphy taking control of this match up early, and now Cedric Alexander counters. What Cedric, there's a swinging neck breaker by Cedric Alexander. Cedric Alexander is so, not completely experienced. This is the first time, I believe, that Patrick Murphy has the experience edge over anyone in singles competition. Cedric Alexander began wrestling in 2011. He competed in such organizations as CNC Wrestle Factory and Ring of Honor on a regular basis with Caprice Coleman. And of course, Cedric Alexander would go on over the next couple of years to make shockwaves in Ring of Honor. And although he never got his due in Ring of Honor and got the chance to challenge for any type of championship, Cedric Alexander would go on to end the undefeated streak of former Impact Grand Champion Moose, of all people. Since that time, Cedric Alexander went on to compete in the Cruiserweight Classic, and he had a strong showing in the Cruiserweight Classic that he would impress Triple H and so many officials that Triple H would sign Cedric Alexander to a WWE contract. And while he hasn't really had the opportunity to shine on 205 Live, you gotta think it's only a matter of time before Cedric Alexander is challenging for Cruiserweight Gold. And the best weapon in his arsenal is the lumbar check that can break so many backs. He has put so many men out with that move that sometimes it could lead to injury. Both men now on the outside. Patrick Murphy looking to take control of this matchup, and he does with an overhead belly-to-belly. We've already listed Patrick Murphy's credentials, but both of these men are natives of North Carolina. They may not be both from Charlotte, but they both live in the North Carolina area. Patrick Murphy, of course, has made shockwaves in the WWE as of late. He recently completed the comeback. Wait a minute. Counter. Cedric Alexander stomps at an another counter. There is an inverted DDT by Patrick Murphy. Patrick Murphy would go on to complete the comeback in the best of five series against Dolph Ziggler. He would also go on to defeat Bobby Roode for the NXT Championship before making it to the main roster. Now, although he has not fared as well on the main roster, you gotta even think that management finally has faith in Patrick Murphy after his impressive comeback in the best of five series. Wait a minute, Camel Clutch locked in, but Cedric Alexander too smart, and he powers out. Cedric Alexander, and wait a minute, Patrick Murphy got the arms hooked. There's a double underhook suplex, and not even a one count. You're not gonna defeat Cedric Alexander that easy. Wait a minute, Irish whip in the ropes, and there is hold number one in the list of 1,004 holds. The arm drag followed up by a double axe handle. This usually potentially leads to the Dirty Deeds. Patrick Murphy, arms hooked, Dirty Deeds, shades of Dean Ambrose. This should be all. One, two, and Patrick Murphy let go. Now, I think at this point, Patrick Murphy is underestimating Cedric Alexander. You do not, wait a minute. Patrick Murphy's got Cedric Alexander with the last call. Last call. Patrick Murphy just devastated Cedric Alexander with the last call. This should be it. One, two, and Patrick Murphy let go again. Patrick Murphy now is just toying with Cedric Alexander. You do not want to do that. Cedric Alexander now on the comeback trail here. Cedric Alexander is fired up. He is letting the fans know about it too. Patrick Murphy steps inside the ring, and now Cedric Alexander with clothesline, followed by another clothesline, and there is a splash in the corner, and now Cedric Alexander ducks the clothesline with a flying clothesline of his own. Cedric Alexander, and wait a minute, Patrick Murphy is now fired up. Oh my God, And now there is two shoulder blocks right there. Cedric Alexander sends Patrick Murphy over the top rope. Patrick Murphy up in the top turnbuckle, which leads to the famous double axe handle. Wow, what a series of events there. That is just too much to call. And now, Irish Whip in the corner. Patrick Murphy has got Cedric Alexander up. Could it be? Oh, one sweep to that. One Winged Angel. Shades of Kenny Omega. Here's the cover. One, two, and Patrick Murphy just continues to toy with Cedric Alexander. You do not want to do that. Cedric Alexander will make you pay big time if you do that. And now Cedric Alexander is up. Cedric Alexander counters with a punch. He's got Patrick Murphy up with a swinging neck breaker. Could have been a lot worse. Wait a minute. Cover. Not even a one count by Cedric Alexander. And Patrick Murphy moves out of the way. And there is a clothesline. Wait a minute. Cover. Ref, turn around. One, two. And Cedric Alexander kicks out at two. Oh man, Cedric Alexander, despite being toyed with and Patrick Murphy underestimating him, he has got the heart and determination to try to pull off a victory in this one. And there's an uppercut by Cedric Alexander. Wait a minute, Cedric Alexander with an underhook T-bone. Cedric Alexander, could he be calling for the Lombard check? This could be it. Cedric Alexander now, he's got Patrick Murphy. There it is. There's the Lombard check. And I guarantee you, Patrick Murphy will be feeling that in the morning. Oh, this could be a huge upset. And Cedric Alexander picks Patrick Murphy up. What a huge mistake. He had Patrick Murphy beat. And now Patrick Murphy takes advantage. Wow. Cedric Alexander may have put up the good fight, but I don't think it is going to be enough. As here it is. Patrick Murphy locks in the Lion Tamer. Cedric Alexander in the center of the ring. Nowhere to go. Oh, but Cedric is fighting, and he has no choice but to tap. Patrick Murphy scores a victory tonight on SmackDown Live against Cedric Alexander. Oh, boy, what a matchup. And there you see some of the replays there. Patrick Murphy, there was one of the last calls, and then there was a one-winged angel. Patrick Murphy just literally underestimated Cedric Alexander, but he still managed to come out with the victory. Boy, what a matchup this was. And there is the Lombard check right there. Cedric Alexander had him beat. Patrick Murphy scores another huge win tonight here on SmackDown Live as he defeats Cedric Alexander in what was a phenomenal, phenomenal classic. Too sweet yourself to that, Patrick Murphy. You deserve this. And we are back in the gorilla position, and this time we don't have to confront... We don't have to confront Mr. Todd Mullen. This is a shocker. A shocker to everyone. Why? Wait, did Todd have to go catch a management meeting or something? Wait, where's Shane? Shane ain't even here. What the hell? Did they ditch their top superstar? Seriously? Whatever, I'm done. And Carmella, once again, this week, is still on her phone. Carmella, seriously? You know, Carmella, That's why you have such a big mouth. You and Big Cass, or should I say Big Ass, are a lot alike. Not you both are egotistical assholes. How about that?
It's Rusev Day!
Hold on just a minute, Rusev. Have you seen Tom Mullen anywhere, Rusev? By any chance? Your star may be rising, but don't let it ever get to that thick head of yours. No one man is bigger than the WWE ever. The McMahons are the first and last name of wrestling, as far as you're concerned. I could kind of agree with that. I'll agree with that as much as I don't want to necessarily agree with you, but, you know, it is what it is. And Jimmy Uso, how you doing? Whatever you are doing in the ring is working. Now that you have the talent down, focus on company goals. We all know how important those can be. Talk to HR for a full list of agendas. Well, my own agenda is to be the best there is, the best there was, and the best that there ever will be, if I can quote Bret the Hitman. Because you got no chance. No chance in hell. Right as I quoted Bret Hart 2, we walked into Mr. McMahon's office. I'm out of here. I'm out of this arena. And ladies and gentlemen, this does it for episode 18 of WWE 2K18, My Career Mode. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you did not catch it in the last episode, here's a quick reminder of this upcoming week. On a normal week, there would be 3 episodes this upcoming week, as there's usually a 1 to 2 day gap between each episode. However, with this week being Thanksgiving and it not being a normal week, episode 19 will air on Tuesday as scheduled. However, episode 20 will air on Wednesday, November 22nd at noon Eastern, ladies and gentlemen. And after that, we're going to air some Crash Bandicoot episodes throughout the rest of the Thanksgiving weekend and episodes of WWE 2K18 My Career Mode will resume on Monday, November 27th, the Monday after Thanksgiving, ladies and gentlemen. So this does it for this episode. Smash that thumbs up button as hard as you possibly can if you enjoyed today's episode. Please share this series on social media. I hope you guys have been enjoying this series just as much as I have being able to do this with y'all. And please subscribe to the channel. I appreciate y'all's love and support. For all of us at Patrick McSparren Productions, this is Patrick McSparren saying so long, and I'll see you soon. Goodbye, mwah, and good night. Bang! This telecast is copyrighted for the private use of our audience. Any use of this telecast, pictures, or descriptions without Patrick McSparren Productions' consent is prohibited. Be sure to subscribe to Patrick McSparren Productions for more exclusive content.